I officially am calling Charlie Abrego the bravest man of the year. Because he just picks up the animals like, yeah, you know, this is the person I brought, the little animal person I brought today.
And it's funny, like, honestly, at the zoo, since I don't take care of the animals, they're in a different building, so they kind of prepare them for me to take. And when they finally, like, actually opened the container, I hadn't seen it just till now. I was like, oh my God, is that coral snake or a milk snake? I thought they were trying to trick me there at the zoo.
Well, this is a milk snake, and it is tiny but adorable, and it actually looks dangerous, but I assume it is not.
It is. So this is a Mexican milk snake. So right here, if you can really tell, so especially on this one, since it's so small, this is actually something you can encounter out here in the valley when you're a coral snake, in a sense. But the colors, they'll be about around this size, maybe a little bit longer, but their colors are very, very similar. But in fact, you have the old riddle. We're going over it. Everybody always asks me every time I bring the milk snake, is the red and yellow bands touch, then it's venomous. So if the black and red bands touch, like this one right here, then it's a non-venomous milk snake.
Very good. And he is, is it a he or a she?
I don't know yet, actually.
He's over here in my watch. It's a very special milk snake. And what are some of the features? Can people, when they go to Gladys Porter Zoo, can they come and like touch it and play with it?
So sometimes on the weekends we have some activities or a presentation that the people can actually get really close to, our guests. And that goes on during midday there at the zoo. But if you do visit them in the herpetarium, which is our reptile house, you'll notice that the milk snake and the coral snake are side by side. So you can like do that little obvious comparison, because it's something we do need to know about here in the valley, because we will encounter, I've been on runs before in the evening, and I'll see a coral snake kind of crawl by. So
you need to step away.
If you see anything in this color, or a snake in general, just leave it alone.
You can't say Channel 4 at noon, we didn't teach you something new,
exactly,
so write
right.
that down. So, of course, we want to encourage everyone to go to Gladys Porter Zoo, especially because this Saturday, are you going to go dance or what?
Yes, I'll try. We have a Zumba going on, so it's a little bit different than your normal Zumba, but yes, we do have from 9:15 to 9:45, we have a Zumba class with Jackie, and so it's going to be really great. You can go on our website for more information about signing up. Basically, it's almost a very, very similar cost as your regular admission, just the child's like $2 more. You get a goodie bag, you get entrance to the zoo, we have wild tales going on. So there's so many, actually there's so much going on Saturday, so it'd be a really great time. And of course, Victoria gave us great weather. Right?
Yes.
She's going to give us great weather, so hopefully it will be really nice, and we'll have a good time.
That's awesome. So how long have you guys been doing the Zumba class?
It's the first time. So
really?
Yeah, so I'll be there, so hopefully, you know, they don't make me go up on stage and
you
do Zumba
should
too.
Make him. If you go, tell him that he has to dance. That's awesome. Well, this little guy looks not so dangerous, ooh, but he wiggles too much. So we're going to say goodbye to the milk snake for now. Charlie,
yes.
thank you for
thank
being
you.
Here with us. We'll be right back with the last check at your forecast.